All right, y'all. Hey, good morning. How y'all doing? Good. My name is Diane Burkholder. I am chair of the LGBTQ Humanist Alliance. How many of y'all, this is the first time even being familiar with the American Humanist Alliance. Y'all didn't know anything about. That's cool. That's what we're here for. This is a community day. This is family. I want you to be unapologetically you today. I need to turn down this playlist. So I'm going to go into announcements and all that later. But we are going to get started a little bit of music to get us like warmed up for the day, because we're going to have a day. It's called the summit. This is a community conversation. You're going to hear some stuff on the stage, but we want really everybody to build with one another. So y'all ready?
We're ready.
Y'all ready?
Are y'all ready?
Y'all ready?
I want to need y'all to help me out a little bit.
Okay.
When we get to the end, all right? Your smile and your touch is amazing, and all the while I will write after years of nothing. It's good to know you. To love you, it's good to know you, it's good to love you. I love your swag, every day is a day I'm grateful. I'll go the mile. What you do, where you go, I'm with you. It's good to know you. It's good to love you. It's good to know you. It's good to love you. To know you, and it's going to be even better to get to know you. each other, to meet each other, to love on each other, to hear each other, to see each other. So, those of you who can sing the high voice, you'll say,
to know you, it's good to see you, it's good to know you, yeah. Ooh. It's good to know you. It's good to see you. Hey, yeah. It's good.
It's good to know y'all. Thank you for saying it. Trey on the drum.
This is our MC for the day, right? That's a good way to get started. Fabulous. So I'm gonna read Roger's bio, which is in your program. So Roger has been a member of the Black Nonbelievers Incorporated for 8 years and currently serves as the chapter organizer and as a local affiliate of the local nonbelievers here in Kansas City. See y'all? DC y'all. You can tell I live in Kansas City, my bad. He's an international singer, recording artist with 20 plus years. Aren't you like 22? How you got 20 plus years? Child, black don't crack. 20-year career in entertainment, work with Grammy-nominated artists Alicia Keys, Robert Glasper, Bilal, Platinum Pied Pipers, and Ndombe? I'm saying that right? Ndombe and others. Roger is a 3-time grant awardee with DC Commission of the Arts and Humanities Faculty of the Richardson School of Music in Tacoma Park and hails from St. Croix. So fabulous, thank you all. He's gonna be our MC for the day and accompanied by Trey, who is a local musician. So those of you that are here in town, I'm gonna let Trey plug his, he has a show tomorrow. I'm gonna let him plug himself for like 2 seconds. Where's your show? Let him know.
So if y'all free tomorrow, I'll be playing at the Eaton Hotel, E-A-T-O-N, on 12th and K Street from 4 to 9. So if you're free, come through. And I also run a jam session every Thursday at BIN 1301 on U Street. It's open for musicians and artists and people who want to come and sing or play an instrument. You can come through BIN 1301 every Thursday from 8 to 11. And hopefully I'll see you tomorrow. Peace. I'm on Instagram if y'all want to hit me up. I'm at TRAE Drummer 84. Peace.
Supporting our local folk, yes. So I want to get started today. Like I said, Roger's going to be our MC for the day, but I want to do some grounding. So I appreciate y'all coming out here on a Saturday. It's a lovely day. Y'all could be out running around, getting your vitamin D in, but y'all in with us, getting your melanin in. So I want to start, though, with the land recognition. Land recognitions are really important that we ground and we talk about the space and the land that we are on. As a step in honoring, toward honoring the truth and achieving healing and reconciliation, we commit to open all public events and gatherings with a statement acknowledging the traditional native lands on which we stand. This land is not ours. This land has been stolen. The acknowledgement is critical to building mutual respect and connection across all barriers and heritage and difference. We open today by acknowledging the history and the present land occupied by the Washington Ethical Society. We are on unceded territory of the Piscataway people, and we pay respects to their elders, past and present. Please take a moment to consider the many legacies of violence, displacement, migration, and settlement that brings us here together today. So I'll give space to that. I also encourage you to, like, when you go back home to your places, acknowledge the land that we're on and give thanks. So with that, I'm going to move into just a little bit about who we are, right? So where's our AHA staff at? We have a couple folk in the room. Hi, so we have staff, so see people raving around. A couple folks are back. I'm not going to put her on the mic, but Rachel is a social justice coordinator. Wave, Rachel. She did all the logistics to make sure that we got here today so as BIPOC could focus on being with y'all. So thank you for stepping into the space and making sure we all got here. So the LGBTQ Humanist Alliance, we seek to cultivate safe and affirming communities, promote humanist values, and achieve full equity through social liberation of LGBTQ persons. So we've been around, the alliances have been around for some years. This is also an open call that y'all can join us to help organize stuff like this. And we decided as this mission that we wanted to really center queer and trans folk of color. And so that's why we're putting on this summit. There are also other alliances, and you will be hearing from some of those folks today, but just to let y'all know, there is a newly formed Latinx Humanist Alliance. Some of those folks are here. Y'all gonna hear from them, about 6 months old. And the Latinx Humanist Alliance is working to correct misrepresentation of Latinx Americans as monolithically religious in American media. And they're going to create a speakers bureau, y'all. So if y'all Latinx or no folk, they're not religious, here's a space to, like, share your stories. We have the Feminist Humanist Alliance, working to make our movement more inclusive by facilitating the scholarships and grants for AHA's annual conference, which is coming up in May. It's actually a virtual conference held all over the country. June, I'm sorry. I thought it was early May. My bad. So they've been facilitating to make sure that it's accessible, and they are creating scholarships. So if you are interested and know folks that are interested, the Feminist Humanist Alliance is actually organizing that. And they're going to be implementing more social justice programs throughout the AHA chapters around the country. And also the Black Humanist Alliance, you will be hearing from Ashton later today, is working on anti-Black racism that's systemic in American education through the federal level advocacy. So they're going to try to introduce some bills, y'all, to help change some policy in this America nation that we live in. So it's just an open invitation. If y'all want to know more about us, find us throughout the day. I'm fluttering around here, and I encourage you to get to know folks. Your name tags, please respect folks' pronouns. If you don't know, please use a name. Ask before giving a hug, as handshakes or hugs. And we also have a healing space downstairs. And I'm actually going to pass it to Roger to tell you about the rest of our day. But thank you all for coming. And our hashtag for the day is Centering the Margins. Thank you.
Thank you, Diane. And thank you all again for listening to my little song over there. It's called It's Good to Know You. And it's really good to know you. And I met some of you already. I look forward to meeting more of you and getting to know you, obviously seeing you, hearing you, and learning with and from you. This is an incredible honor for me. It is not a normal thing for me to be. It's normal for me to be on a mic, but it's normal more for me to just play and then go away. So this is going to be a new thing for me, but I'm really glad to have the opportunity. Thank you again, Diane, for the warm introduction. And I want to thank the American Humanist Association as well for all the work that they've done to prepare this moment for us. We are in for some real treats today, and there's going to be a lot of good ground that we cover. I want to just one more time, just to reiterate that we're going to abide by those community agreements that Diane mentioned, and it's really important that we keep that in mind and keep that space in mind that we acknowledge.